and welcome everyone. My name is Nathalie van der Wielen, and in this movie we will show you how to create an export template for a book. Here you can see an example of the template we are going to make in this movie. We first select a number of records and click on File to go to the Backstage section. Then click on Export and choose Create New Report Template. In the first step, we have to select the fields to be used on a template. The ID and the name field are selected by default. The assimilation field is a field containing subfields. All of them can be selected in one go. When all fields are selected, click on the Next button. Then choose the format of export. Here we will choose for the PDF file format. It is optional to give a name to the new template. We will call it Yeastbook. Click Next and finish to open the Report Designer. A default display is shown in the print preview. Go to the Report Designer tab to be able to edit the display. First, we will add a title by dragging a label to the template. Double-click to modify the text on the label. Use the buttons in the ribbon on top to change the size of the text and to make it bold. The Properties window can be opened to see directly all the properties of the selected item on the template. Now we will drag a rich text box to the template. In this type of text box, it is possible to use different font styles. In the field list on the right side, you see in the reference part the list of all the fields that were selected for this template. We will now add a calculated field. Right-click and choose Edit Expression. In the expression editor, you can build a string from data from different fields. Here we will concatenate the species name, the authors, and the year. When the expression is complete, click OK. Now the calculated field can be dragged onto the template. Go to the Print Preview tab to see the results of the changes. On top, you can see now that there is the concatenated field with the species name, the author, and the year. On the top right, you can see the editor's information, and on the top left, you see the title. Then we will continue editing the template. I will move some of the fields on the template to make space for the actual fields to be put there. I will again drag the calculated field to the template. In this case, to the Yeast 2011 section, meaning it is going to be repeated for each of the selected records in the grid. Then we will add a new label and call it Authors. All the fields selected for this export are shown below, so we will here select the Authors field. For all selected fields, the label with the name of the field is present. Here we will take the Year field label. From the field list on the right, you can drag the field content. Click on the small blue button on the top right of the label to change its parameters. Here we will allow the label to grow where there is a lot of information, and it can use multi-line, though it should not wrap the words. From the left panel we can drag a line onto the template. A new label will be placed called Fermentations. The fields regarding the fermentation will be placed just below. It is possible to select multiple items on the template and to change the size of all of them in one go. The ID field will not be used and therefore I can simply delete it from the template. When we go to the Print Preview tab, we can see that the first part is looking nice already, though we need to improve the names of the fields. Double-click on the name label and adapt the names. We need to repeat this for the right list of names too. In the print preview, you can see that it looks better now. Then we have to add the fields for the assimilation section. When all fields are in the right place, go to the print preview to see the results. And then we will place the remaining fields in the right positions. When you select multiple boxes on the template, it is possible to update the properties in one go. For example, the multi-line and the word wrap. The detail report band will not be used in this example, and therefore it can be deleted. Use the page break to make sure that after this point the new information will be displayed on a new page. In the footer, we will add a line and a label with the last update information. To add page numbers to the template, use the page info option. The last thing we want to add to this template is a table of content. We will add a report header. This is a section that contains information which will be displayed once per report. Drag the table of content to the template. You see that the table of content is there, but it's not displayed correctly. A bookmark needs to be added. On the calculated field, click on the blue button and add the name of the bookmark. Then go to the properties window and bind there the species name. Now the table of content is showing the species name of all selected records. Click on the name to go directly to the page showing the information about the species. Click Save Template to the database to be able to use the template later again. Other users may be able to use this template too. It depends on the rights. I will now select more records in the grid. Go to the backstage section and click on print. Select the yeast book template and see the preview on the right.